next concern that we have is just making sure that we understand how to go through the restock process and use the purchase orders to create purchases, to send those to our suppliers, and to receive those purchases back into inventory to update our inventory stock levels. Let's cancel here and exit here. And this is going to bring us back to the control panel here just before we actually go into the purchase order system. There's a couple of settings that we probably want to be aware of. Let's go into number 4, setup, and letter G, setup screen. And let's go to the inventory tab. So we have a setting here that allows us to do cost averaging. It's currently disabled. And if we enable that, it basically averages the quantity of items times the cost of each item that's come in on our PO system, and it's going to do the cost averaging for us. If you don't want that, we can just leave that disabled here. The other feature that we want to be aware of is the feature for how and when we deduct ingredients. So we can set that to never. We can set it to occur at the end of the sale or at the time of preparation. So if we are a bakery, then we might want to actually deduct those ingredients at the time that we're making the product, because it's different. It's coming out right then, not necessarily when we're making the sale. As opposed to when we're making a cup of coffee, the items and the ingredients are actually coming out at the time of sale, because at that point is when we're actually moving ingredients around. So let's go ahead and exit there. And let's go ahead and talk about how we use the purchase order system in Restaurant Pro Express. We're going to go to section number 5, which is administrative. And then our purchase orders feature is going to be on letter H here. Let's go ahead and click on that. And this is what you get when you first come into the purchase order screen. We have the option to view open purchase orders, and we can view closed purchase orders here. We have one in the list. And we can choose to review the different types of purchase orders we can create, which are standard, which is where we're going to issue a purchase order out to a vendor. Return to vendor, which is where we're sending items back, usually because they're damaged or it was a wrong order. Or direct store delivery, which is kind of an on-the-fly purchase order receipt. We're not going to handle those in this session right now. Let's go back here and just see what we would see when we first come in. And let's go ahead and click add and create our first purchase order. It's going to ask us if we're doing a standard or return to vendor. I'm going to pick standard. And there's kind of two different places here where we need to make sure we're picking the same information for the vendor. On this first page, which is called the general information tab, we have a list of our vendors and we need to pick supply co. Now, when we come over here to the add item screen, we're actually going to see a list of items. We need to make sure that we're on the same vendor. If we're not, then we'll have some confusion trying to pick items. In this case, we are on the same vendor, and you'll see that we have our two cups here. There's a few controls on this screen. We want to kind of just go over what they do. The first one is the checkbox here for at reorder point. And if we click this checkbox, the system runs a check on every item that's associated with this vendor, and it looks at the number in stock and compares that to the reorder level. And if it is below level, it needs to be reordered, then it's going to display those items here. If there are items that are above that reorder level, they're not going to show up when we check that box. That gives us a quick way to kind of isolate the lowest items that are needing the most urgent attention from us in terms of ordering. The other features that we have here, we can search for a specific item. This just brings up our search box that you're pretty familiar with to search for items. We could pull those in and add them. The filter allows you to filter by part of the item number. We can also find a part number, which is the vendor part number, and search by that. And the show all rows actually just redisplays everything. So if we've done some sort of a filter and we click this one, it's just going to show everything back up again. So there's a couple of quick ways that people like to reorder based on their low level items. One is they want to check this box and scroll through the list of items that are low level and manually click on one and then double click it and populate it onto the list below for reorder. Another way that people like to go through here is they like to hold down the shift key. So they'll click the first item, hold down the shift key, and then click the mouse again on the next item and highlight a group of items that they're interested in reordering. And when you do that way, you can click the add selected items and it's going to populate those down below in addition to what's already down in the order list. So that's another way to do it. The third way that we can add low level items quickly, if we're kind of just ready to get it done, we can click reorder low stock items, and that's going to bypass us having to check a box or highlight anything, and it's literally going to throw everything on the list that meets that criteria for that vendor. So if that's your quick way to do it. Obviously, the only downside to that would be that you're going to get everything, and if there's certain things you want to limit your reorder on or maybe adjust those settings, and you'd be getting everything here. So you really wouldn't want to do what I just did and add those items multiple times. So what I'm going to do to kind of get out of this menu is I'm going to cancel and then just go back in and start a new purchase order. So we start with a clean slate. Let's go back and pick our supply co and add items. All right. Now, for our purposes, let's just double click on an item and talk about what happens once it's on the purchase order. Let's go ahead and add both of our cups since they're below reorder level. There are a couple of features down here that we can control in the order items that are actually on the order, and that allows us to change the quantity that we want to order on the fly, because sometimes even though you have a reorder level and a reorder quantity, sometimes you may be going to a season where you know you're going to do more business and you know you need to order more than your typical restocking points. So we can manually intervene by clicking on the item that you're interested in, and you're going to click right here on the case ordered field. And when you click on that number one, it's going to give us the ability to order more cases than our standard reorder. So if I want to reorder two instead, I'm going to click that and click OK. We will notice that when you order more cases, the system is intelligent to calculate what that quantity of single units that is being updated. So if we're ordering two cases instead of one and there's 50 per case, the system automatically updated the quantity from 100 to 50. The other feature that we have right here on the screen is the ability to change the number set per case. Now that was actually controlled in the inventory maintenance screen where we're setting the number per case. But if for some reason we notice a need to change that, maybe our company is changing their pack size or we've made some sort of an error, we can click on the number per case right here with our mouse. We're going to single click on the left mouse key and then we're going to hit the space key on the keyboard. That brings up the ability for us to adjust on the fly how many we're packing per case, and the system's going to update that in the system as well. Now I'm going to go ahead and set that back to where it was. Just wanted you to see how that worked. And the last thing that we can do here that's really helpful is if we do are in the process of making the order and we realize that the cost has changed, we have a chance to affect that on the fly before we send off the purchase order. We can do the same thing here. We can left click our mouse button in the cost field, hit the space key, and it's going to allow us to update the cost for that case of items. And then once I set my cases ordered back to a number other than zero, it's going to show the calculation of the cost and the extended cost based on the number of cases. And down here at the bottom, we're going to see a few other stats: total cost received, amount remaining, total cost ordered. Now that we've got those set in place and we've learned how to use that, let's go ahead and save the purchase order, which would be typically the next step here. And the system's going to ask us, do we want to print a copy of this PO? Typically, when we're generating POs like this, yeah, we're going to want to copy these, and we're going to either want to save them to a digital format that we can email to our vendor, or we're going to print them off and fax them, something like that. So I'm going to go ahead and click yes here. And I'm going to print to full size. And what this is going to do is pop up to my main screen here, a full size purchase order. And this is going to be in a PDF format. It's going to show us the breakdown here of the items, the quantities, cases, and the breakdown and the cost and all of those features. So a couple of little side notes here. Number one, if the format looks off when you run this report, you probably have your receipt printer or some other non-standard printer set up as your default printer for Windows. So we can go down here to the Windows Start button, go to Devices and Printers, And on POS Nation imaged systems, you're going to see a PDF creator. If you right click on that and set that as the default printer, then this checkbox right here, then that will fix it. You can reprint the report. Oftentimes, if you have the receipt printer here, one of the other printers set up as the default, you're going to run into format issues when you try and do that report. And if you needed to go back in and reissue that report after you've gone through that process, we can come back here to the existing open PO, double click it, come back into the system, and then down here you have your print feature where you can go back through and reissue the rendering of that order. You will notice here that the vendor information set to supply code doesn't have really much information in here. It has all the information for ship to because we filled that out in the company info tab under the setup screen. The way that we can get the vendor information in here is we're going to go back into vendor maintenance and actually fill in the address portion of those records, and that will take care of that. Up here on the left-hand corner of this screen, we're going to be able to either print the report off, which we can print to a standard printer, 8.5 by 11, or we can print to our PDF creator, which just prints it out on the screen and gives us a copy that we can save to the desktop. The other thing that we can do is we can export the report and use PDF that way, and that's just another way to get it quickly onto the desktop. We could pick Adobe PDF format, desktop, and call it PO number 2, something like that. When you're done here, we're just going to close this out, and we're going to exit out to the main screen here so that we can talk about when we're done creating purchase orders, we've sent them off to our vendors. The next step then is how are we going to receive those items from inventory when they come in on the order, on the shipment. To do that, we're going to go back into the purchase order screen, and we're going to find our open purchase order and double click on it. And there's a couple of different ways that we can go about receiving items. So let's talk about the three ways real quick. One way, it's the very quickest way, it's kind of a catch-all, is to just hit the receive all button. And you'll notice down here that there were 100 quantity ordered for this first line item, two cases, and then we show the quantity received here set to zero because we haven't received order quantities against this line item yet. If we click the receive all button, it's going to assume that we're receiving everything that we ordered for every single item. It's just going to populate those fields to match the quantity ordered. The next way that we can receive is by clicking the receive item screen, and what that's going to do is prompt us to pick which line number we're talking about receiving first, and then enter the quantity received for that specific line item. So the line item is the first column over here on the left hand side, corresponding 1 and 2. If we pick line item number 1, it's going to ask us, are we receiving eaches or cases? I'm going to go ahead and say I'm receiving cases. And it's going to start out prompting us for a default saying, hey, you know, you ordered 2, did you receive 2? And we can either accept that or we can change it to 1 if we want to, or 0, or whatever we end up having actually on hand from the shipment. The third way that we can receive inventory is by using this tool called the receiving screen. The receiving screen allows us to do 2 different methods. We're going to be able to scan barcodes and enter quantities, and if we just scan the barcode on one of these items, if the item number that we actually have is a literal barcode on the package, we can scan that, key in the quantity, and hit submit, and that's going to count the quantity in the boxes up that way. The other way that we can do it is by invoking what we call quick scan. When we invoke quick scan and we scan the barcode, it's going to assume that every time it scans a barcode and hits that, it's going to add 1 case quantity to the receipt order. So we can use that tool if we'd like. We can go back through here and delete items. When you're done, you can click the commit all button and be out of this screen. For our purposes right now, let's just say that we're going to receive all just to get started. Now let's say that we like to use this method. We've got a lot of products. We don't want to count everything, but we did realize on our order that maybe there are 1 or 2 things that did not show up on the order, and we have a problem trying to adjust that, because what happens is after you do a receive all, and you go to the quantity received here, there's really no way. You can double click on it, you can hit the space bar. Nothing really happens to allow us to adjust that quantity received. So the trick is, if you want to go back and either modify that to none received, or maybe a partial shipment was received and you just want to close out the order, not chase the vendor down for those items, then you can actually go back to the case ordered and change that to a lower level, and then hit the receive all button again, and it's going to adjust the quantity received to match what was actually shown on the updated order. So if you need to adjust the quantity received, you actually have to handle the quantity order, the cases order, to do that and get it right. Otherwise, after the fact, after you close out your purchase order altogether, you can always go back into item by item and use instant PO to adjust them. So if you just receive all and you've got a few items that you really didn't receive, then you can go back into those and do an instant PO for a negative quantity and reduce and remove what you accidentally added in here. Whenever you're done with the order and you got everything set up, what we want to do is we're going to click update here. And this is what actually commits the changes of these inventory levels to our stock levels. And if you look down here, we should have added one case of the 12-ounce cups, 50 single units, and the same thing for the 8-ounce cups. So we had 49 in stock before we started this, so we should have 99 in stock now when we go back and look. So let's exit out of there, and let's just go take a peek in our inventory maintenance screen. Look at those. We'll actually search for the ingredients department because that's where those are. And there's our 12-ounce cups. We now have 99 in stock, and we have 99 of the 8-ounce cups. Whenever we're satisfied that our stocks have been received and we're happy to close out that purchase order, we can go back into the purchase order, and we're just going to hit the close button. When you hit the close button, it's going to notify us here that we're going to close this and it cannot be reopened. Are we sure that we're done? We can click yes. Now that purchase order has gone away from the display screen here. If we want to look at it, we can always go back to our closed orders and double click on it and review what we ordered and what we said we received, cost and such. We can even print it out again, but we can't modify this purchase order again. If we need to make any additional changes to inventory, we can either create a new purchase order or we can do an instant PO.